So we've been solving this differential equation, x dot equals ax. A is a 2x2 matrix. X is a column vector, x1 and x2. In the next series of lectures, I want to show you how to visualize the solution of this equation. Those diagrams are called phase portraits, and the visualization is done in what's called the phase space of the solution. So x is a column vector, x1 and x2, and the visualization then draws the solution of x2 versus x1. So there's something, first we have to say something about this solution. The origin here, the 0, 0 value, is called a fixed point. So that's the point right at the origin. The meaning of a fixed point is that if the solution starts at 0, 0, so if the initial condition for x was 0, 0, then it stays at 0, 0 for all time. So the solution is fixed at 0, 0 because the derivative is 0. So the origin is considered a fixed point. It's also sometimes called an equilibrium point of the equation. An equilibrium point can be stable or unstable. So if an equilibrium point is stable, it means that all nearby solutions will be attracted to the equilibrium. But if an equilibrium point is unstable, it means all solutions will run away from the equilibrium. Because this is a linear equation, it doesn't matter whether you're near or far from the equilibrium. If this fixed point or equilibrium is stable, all solutions will then converge onto the fixed point. Unstable, they will all run away. So in the next few lectures, I want to classify the behavior of this diagram. This diagram we solve by putting some initial condition here, so say over here. So this would be the value x1 at t equals 0 and x2 at t equals 0. And then follow what the trajectory of this initial point will be. Okay? So that means we solve the differential equation and we follow where this point moves in the phase space. And we will then draw diagrams for several initial conditions surrounding this fixed point and see what the diagram looks like. Okay. In this introductory video, I want to try and classify what the different solutions will look like. So let me make a table here. So the solutions, or the qualitative nature of the solutions, will depend on the eigenvalues and the eigenvectors of the matrix A. So if we just concentrate on the eigenvalues, I can make a table of eigenvalues and then a fixed point. How does the fixed point behave? Okay. So what could the eigenvalues look like? They can be real. So let's say real eigenvalues. So two real distinct eigenvalues. And they can both be negative. Okay? So two negative real eigenvalues. Then we know that the solution has an exponential behavior. And because the eigenvalue is negative, it's a decaying exponential. So in this case, all of the solutions will, all the trajectories will converge onto the origin. We call this fixed point a stable node. Okay. The other case would be real, and both eigenvalues are positive. Then the exponentials are growing in time. Everything's running away from the origin. This is called an unstable node. okay? The other case then is one positive and one negative eigenvalue. This is called a saddle point. Okay, the fixed point here is called a saddle point. We'll see what that means is that along one of the eigenvectors, the solution is going into the origin, and along another eigenvector, the solution is running away from the origin. Okay, apart from real eigenvalues, we can have complex eigenvalues. Okay, and then there are two cases here. They're all called spiral points, but what matters here is the sign of the real part. So if the real part is negative, the real part of the complex eigenvalue is negative, then this is called a stable spiral. And the solution then spirals into the origin. If the real part is positive, this is called an unstable spiral. Okay, so that's going to be our classification of the fixed point, and the diagram, the phase portrait for these different cases will all have a distinctive look for them. So let me review. We're looking for a picture that represents the solution of our system of first order equations. That picture is called a phase portrait, and the character of the picture will depend on the type of eigenvalues that we get from the matrix A. I'm Jeff Chasnoff. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.